closer to building a huge launch pad that will keep commercial launches and jobs coming to the Space Coast.
NASA has agreed to let the state look into building the pad at the Kennedy Space Center.
WESH 2's Dan Biller reports that's a change in the way things have been done.
On a pristine patch of wilderness at the Kennedy Space Center, Florida wants to build a new launch pad. It's a place where birds, beasts, and alligators roam now, but where rocket fuel and money could flow in the future.
We want the commercial launch activity and the jobs associated with it to be here in Florida as opposed to Texas.
And now the way is clearer after NASA agreed to let studies begin. At first, the space agency wouldn't agree.
This is a critical, important step. That is a demonstration to the marketplace that Florida is still in this game.
Engine start.
There's already a new launch pad in Virginia, and Texas and Georgia are ahead of Florida in plans to build pads there. Companies such as SpaceX want to use state-owned launch pads because it'll be easier and cheaper to do business that way than on Air Force-controlled pads at the Cape.
We want to see those new emerging space systems plant and grow here in Florida. This area knows how to do launch pads.
That's why Florida has targeted a spot called Shiloh, north of the federal launch pads, but still on NASA property, where the state could build a big pad for the biggest rockets. The Kennedy Space Center is built on a wildlife refuge, so the new state launch pad would be no different from the shuttle pads built amid wildlife habitat. Still, opposition to the new pad is expected to come from environmental groups. And so the first step is an environmental impact statement to see whether a new pad could coexist with nature and keep jobs from moving to Virginia or other states. At the Kennedy Space Center, Dan Biller, WESH 2 News.